Hello everybody, Bradley here, and recently in the YouTube algorithm, I have noticed a lot of people going back, or a lot of new people kind of coming in for the first time, and searching for Civ 6 tutorial videos, specifically the ones that go over starting locations for cities, so I thought it's a good time to kind of redo my old tutorial on this topic, and talk to you guys again about how to settle your first city in your Civilization 6 games. We are going to approach this by loading in as a random leader on a Pangea map. That'll give us the most variability to talk about some leaders that may have different start biases that you are looking to take advantage of that may be bad for other civs. And Pangea gives a good mix of just stuff, right? You got coast, you got inland, you got rivers, you got mountains, you got hills, you got all of it. And so we'll talk about all that as we go through, but we will at least expose ourselves to it with a Pangea map. We are also going to rate the starts in one of five tiers so you guys can kind of get a sense of what I feel is a great start, a good start, an okay start, a bad start, or a terrible start. Those are kind of the five tiers we are going to work with. So we're going to look at a few starts, decide for a variety of reasons why they might be great all the way to terrible or somewhere in the middle, and by the end maybe you'll have learned something about how to settle cities in Civilization 6. We have rolled into our first start, and before we talk about this starting location, I want to talk about how I'm going to decide how good a starting location is and whether or not I should play this save, or what is the best tile to settle my first city. I have decided to do this by taking into account six different things that I would normally kind of look at in a starting location. The first of these two are mandatory. If I do not have these two, it is automatically a bad or terrible start. The first of the two kind of mandatory things that I am looking for in every start is some source of housing. Now, you get housing by settling on freshwater here, like a river or a lake or an oasis or whatever it is, or by settling on the coast. Now, the amount of housing you get for that is different, but I'm looking for some source of housing. A freshwater start is usually my preference, but a coastal start, especially for coastal-based civs, is fine as well. The next thing I'm looking for is that I can settle this start by turn two. There's only so many turns in a civilization game, and kind of waiting till turn three or four to settle your first city is often not worth it. It's usually more worth it to just reroll. So if I don't have fresh water or an ocean to settle on or some sort of housing, and I can't settle it by turn two, or I'm missing either one of those things, it's probably going to be a bad or terrible start. Now, there's four other things I'm going to take into consideration here, and I'm looking for two out of the four other things as well. The first of these four things, the kind of supplementary ones that I'm looking for, is yields. Now, we'll dive deep into yields in a little bit here, but I'm looking for four food and four production total in kind of my first two tiles that I'm working. We'll talk about it in a minute, but four food, four production total is usually a good place to start. It's not the end all and be all, but it is a good place to start. I'm also looking for good surrounding tiles. When you settle a city, you're gonna have your first ring of tiles, and then I'm looking at that second ring of tiles to see if there are any really good tiles in there that I can grow into. If my city is not perfect off the hop, but it's gonna grow into, or I can buy the tiles to have it grow into a really great city later, maybe it's not so bad. The next is wonder and districting possibilities. If my start gives me the chance to build some really good districts or some wonders that I might wanna take a look at, then it's obviously better than a start that doesn't allow me to do those things. The last of these four things I am just going to sum up and call leader synergies. Desert typically is something you don't want to spawn next to, but if you're Mansa Musa, all of a sudden desert is a lot more appealing. Or if you are Nubia, desert is a lot more appealing. So not every start is terrible for every leader, and so sometimes you'll take into account what specifically your leader is good at. For instance, if you're playing as the Khmer and your start is on a river, well, you want to build holy sites on rivers, so that increases how good your start is. So I've spawned in as Scythia here, so I don't have anything super crazy to worry about other than the normal stuff, and I'm really enjoying this start. If we settle on these hills right here, I will settle it by turn two, which is awesome, so let's just go ahead and do that. And from there, I have my 2-2 start with a 2-2 tile to work. So if I go and click here, you can see I'm working the 2 food and the 2 food here, that's 4 food, and then the 2 production, the 2 production, that is 4 production, so I've kind of met my requirement there. I'm gonna grow into this tile, which is a really good tile. Once I put these camps down, I'm gonna start getting some gold, so that's really nice. I have a good wonder possibility here once the camps go down in the Temple of Artemis, and from there I can make a really good theater square, a commercial hub, and I can kind of work some districts in. This tundra kind of sucks a little bit here, but mostly I think this is a good start. All right, we are spawning in as Rome. I can't wait to see what we get here. Rome is one of those civs that just anything works, right? Rome is one of the most versatile civs in the game. I recommend playing Rome if you are a new player here. Most starts you can make work with Rome. So Roma has a bigger spectrum of starts that I would consider either good or great, or just okay. There's a big variety of okay starts as well. So let's see what we get here. So this is interesting. This is not a bad or terrible start. This is just going to be an okay start. There's a lot of good tiles around, you know, 2-2, 3-1, 2-2, 2-2. There's a lot of stone here. These two specifically that we can just kind of get rid of to chop out a wonder, chop out a settler, something like that, and we won't miss that. So there's a lot of chopping opportunities. There's actually three stone here. If you want to take stone circles, you know, Carl would love that. But this start is not, you know, there's no great synergies here with the leader. There's no great wonder opportunities here that I'm looking at. There's nothing crazy going on, but we're just going to settle in place. I can settle by turn two. I'm on fresh water. I do have some good tiles to work. You may have been able to settle down here by the marsh and work these 2-2 tiles as well. I'm getting close. You know, I got 5 food and 2 production or 4 food and 3 production. It's not perfect, but it's not terrible either. This is just the epitome of an okay start. All right, so we're spawning in as Harald here. Harald is obviously a coastal civ. You want to get these Viking longships out early. So I'm excited to see what we get in a coastal start here. This will be a little bit different and give us a few different things to evaluate. But this is obviously a great kind of example of taking a start consideration and kind of molding it around a leader. Typically, I'd rather settle on a river, but obviously as Harald, I'd much rather settle on a coast. And so it's changing my thinking already on what is a good or great start that I might be able to use or exploit to win this game nice and quick. This is actually a really, really awkward start. And the reason for that is my two best harbor spots are right here on this tile and right here on this tile. The problem is if I go all the way down here to put my capital next to this harbor, that's way too late to be settling. And it's not a very good settle. And if I come and move down here or up here, one of these two tiles for my settle, I'm taking a pretty huge risk insofar as I don't really know what's happening. So what I would recommend moving this out to the wheat tile and then just seeing, and if you don't like it, you can reload the autosave. I am kind of tempted right now just to settle in place, get my city down turn one. What I will have is a 2-2 tile and a 3-1 tile to work. Not the worst right away. If I want a little bit of production, I've got up here. I get the silk pretty quickly as well for some amenities and some culture, which is nice. And I still get a decent harbor right here later that I'm not too upset that I'm getting. And so it's not the worst thing in the world. It's not the best thing either. This is just a perfectly serviceable, a definitely okay start. A little bit of a bonus though, as Harald in this start, is I still get the housing from being on a river. So maybe this is just, it's not, maybe this is good. Maybe just being able to get the housing from the freshwater while still getting a coastal start is good because you normally have to trade one for the other. But either way, this is somewhere between kind of high okay and low good. It's serviceable, you can make it work and probably win this game pretty easily. Just for curiosity's sake, I moved over. If you had settled the wheat, you would have got a good harbor, some good tiles around. I don't know if that changes much, and you've lost the fresh water. So overall, I think we made a decent decision here. High okay or a low good start. The new Khmer are absolutely bonkers. A very, very powerful civ. Mainly, we're just looking for lots of rivers here. Holy sites are granted a major adjacency bonus with rivers. What you can then do is kind of work your faith around that bonus and just stockpile all of the food in your empire and have these ridiculously high population cities. That's a maybe more advanced strategy, but just as your typical kind of new civ player, as the Khmer, we're going to want to look to put some holy sites on rivers, and it looks like we're going to be able to do that. This start is very, very meh. There are some okay tiles around. I'm excited to see the rivers here for my holy sites. These two woods are going to get bamboozled by this volcano, so I'm going to have to chop these pretty quick. But also, I can't really put districts here because they're going to get bamboozled by the volcano. And there's just not a lot of inspiring stuff around. You know, maybe we can build a Petra up here. If you're playing on a lower difficulty, maybe you get the pyramids up here. I'm going to come across and settle this city here. The reason why I'm going to do that is I would like to have a space that I can put a holy site where I don't need to chop anything. If you take a look at early game here, we're going to chuck this holy site down. If we take a look at the early game here, what I'm going to want to do is head up into astrology, probably before I get mining to be able to chop the woods. Now, that's not always the case, but it might be the case that you come up to astrology and you want to build your holy site before you chop the woods. And so that gives you the option. There's just not a lot that's inspiring here. What we can do is we also have a spot for the Mabodi Temple, though. These woods are going to have to go, but the Mabodi Temple needs to be placed on woods. It's a great religious wonder here, so we are going to be able to do that as well. So overall, this is not a terrible start. It's workable. You do have a luxury resource right here. You have three kind of chops right here we're going to look to get rid of. You got a decent food tile and the honey on the other side. You got gypsum right here as well. So, I mean, these luxuries aren't inspiring. This isn't very inspiring, but it's certainly not the end of the world. I'm going to go low good on this one, but not high bad. Definitely in the low good area, just because it's very meh. It's very okay. Mapuche. All right, with Mapuche, we're looking for all of the normal stuff here. There's not much we're looking for that's out of the norm for the kind of our starting requirements that we've been talking about already. Oh, baby. Okay, lots to talk about here. Now, this is something I didn't talk about at the beginning because it doesn't really change where you put your first city. And this is mostly a video of like where to actually click the settle button. But being on a continent splint is a really, really good start. So if you're trying to make a decision, hey, my start is meh or okay. But if you're on a continent split, kind of add that into the consideration pool. Being on a continent split means you have access to more luxury resources, which means more amenities. And it means it's a good place to be settling your cities. This doesn't usually apply to first settles, which is what we're looking at in this video, but anytime you see these geothermal fissures, you can't place anything on them until the very end of the game. So they make good tiles to settle on because you still get the science kind of in your city center there, and then you've used the tile you can't otherwise use, and it still gives the campus adjacency bonus. And so we're not going to settle on this tile because it's not on any fresh water, and that's one of my mandatory things, or it's not on any housing, sorry, but hey, you know what? It's there, and if you see more of these throughout the map, especially some that are on freshwater, then it's probably worth settling on them. Now, I've got a lot of good options with this star. We do have a volcano right here. I'm just gonna move my warrior. It's kind of hard to pick where exactly I want it to go. I've got these two deer resources here. We're gonna pick up some gold. We're gonna be able to put down the Temple of Artemis. I'll move up a little bit, and nothing crazy inspiring up there. I'm actually really torn on where I want to settle this first city. The reason is incense isn't a very good tile, so I'd like to settle a city over here. The issue is if I settle in place here, I can't settle a city on top of the incense. So I'm just trying to figure out with the information I have whether or not I think that's worth trying to do or not. This start is interesting. There's a lot of different ways you can go about it. I'm going to choose a really, really kind of bold path here and try and go for the Temple of Artemis or the Oracle. I know I'll be able to get one of them. What I kind of want to do is make use of these kind of rainforest tiles that I don't want. If I just simply settle on it, then I don't get to chop it later, and I would love to chop it later. So if I move down a tile here, I still get to settle on turn one, which is valuable to me. I'm still on the freshwater. I still have good tiles that I can immediately work. What I do gain is the ability to chop this without settling on it, and the ability to kind of chop this up here into a Temple of Artemis once I put this camp down. The Oracle will be good right here, and two wonders with two districts. Your city center here counts as a district. We'll make this a +5 theater square with a +3 campus, and you know, having a good capital with a good campus and a good theater square gives you a really good base of production for your game, so we're going to settle right here. There are another couple of good settles as well. You can make an argument to move down one more. You could have made an argument to move up. There are a few different options. I'm sure if we kept moving this warrior, we could have figured it out and had a little bit of a better idea. However, I'm gonna go with this is a good start, and Ngulu Mapu is here. Tamar, oh so good at defense, baby. Oh so good at defense. Give me them walls. There's nothing we're looking for with Tamar other than the normal stuff, but Tamar's cool. Play Tamar, you'll have fun. I think my best options with Tamar here to settle on either one of these Plains Hill tiles. That will give me a 2-2 start. I do lose the chop, but I am more excited about the 2-2 start than the chop, I think, especially rather than settling in place. I just feel like there's a little more going on down here. I still get a Temple of Artemis tile up here. I can still build a good campus where my settler currently is. You know, the two mountains there will at least make it a +2, and I can sauce in a commercial hub or something if I want that to be a +3 campus later. So that's not the worst. I'm gonna move over here, and we've made our choice to settle. Again, I don't want to settle past turn two, so we shall do so. Tbilisi is down. Now that I take a look around, you know, I'm happy I moved down here. We got an early camp. We can go for Temple of Artemis again. We have some gypsum here, which is nice. We have a diamond tile here, which is really nice. You can see if you look back at some of the other luxury tiles, you know, some of them are pretty bleak. The incense in the last game was like 1-1-1. This is 2-1 and then 3 gold, so it's just way more valuable, and we haven't even worked it yet either. So these are just typically better resources to have. And so I'm excited with this. This is definitely kind of a high good start. we have loaded in here as Japan, and boy oh boy does this start suck. So as Japan, what we are looking for is kind of what we have. What we are looking for with Japan is some flatland tiles to be able to build districts on. Now you can kind of make districts mash together anywhere. Having a built-in space to do that is kind of nice. All districts receive an additional standard adjacency bonus. So what we're looking for is to have districts placed next to each other to achieve that bonus. What we don't have here is anything kind of inspiring along the way. All of our freshwater tiles, we have 1, 2, 3 freshwater tiles and tiles that we can settle within 2 turns, and all of them kind of pull us farther away than the things that look good. These tiles look good up here, this tile looks good up here, and yet we're gonna have to settle kind of farther away or right in place. And if we settle right in place here, which I think is the best option, you could make an argument that going and settling on the T gives us a little bit of science and then gives us a coastal city here to work with. But even then, I'm not really, you know, oh boy, this is bad. This is bad news bears. I am gonna settle in place here. There's just not of the things I like. We're not getting a really good start. We got no immediate tiles to work. So I'm getting like 4 food, 2 production. It's not really what I'm after. I did get the fresh water, which is nice. I do have some synergy here. I can put a campus there and then I can chuck that in and throw a commercial hub here, and that's gonna be okay, I suppose. But overall, this is pretty underwhelming. What I am gonna look to do early on is buy this tile right away. It'll give me a better tile to work, but also give me this one faith to start ticking up for my pantheon. So this is bad. This is bad. This is our first bad start. I'm not here for it. It's not terrible though. It is not terrible. It is just bad. We are here with Gandhi. I was just checking to see if there was anything crazy here that we need to look out for. There is not, so let's just begin the game. Oh, yay, okay, this is lots of good stuff to work with. So while tea isn't my favorite resource, I've got a built-in industry here if you're playing with Monopolies and Corporations mode. If you're not, you've just got a bunch of resources here you can trade with the people you are going to find. So that is awesome. I'm a little bit disappointed actually that I can't really settle on this tea tile. I would have loved to settle on it to kind of acquire that without working on it. This is the easiest settle in place ever though. All I've got to do is settle right in place. I've got a 2-2 tile here. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 really good tiles to work early on here. I have a whole bunch I can do with these resources. Districting is a little bit tricky here. You know, I'm not a big fan of where I can put my districts. I don't have that river holy site adjacency. There's no mountains around, so I'm gonna have to make do with what I can. A government plaza is going to be really important here. You can see a situation where once we see the rest of the map, we may decide to throw a government plaza here, and that might be the start of, you know, let's call it a campus maybe. Maybe that's going down, and maybe that's a little interesting. And then maybe we get an oracle over here. There's the oracle. So you chuck a commercial hub down, not commercial, but theater square down. And boy, that's looking a little bit interesting. And then from there, you settle another city kind of up here. And then that city uses the government plaza for a commercial hub possibly, right? So we're making this work. This is I don't want to call it great. There's something about great that you just know it's a great start. This is upper good. The districting is letting me down a little bit, but the wonders we like are here. You can put down any districts you want with the government plaza. Is there any preserve possibilities? There's no preserve possibilities. And so this is just an upper good start. All right, we are here as Montezuma, and other than looking like Montezuma wants to murder somebody, which is, you know what, fair enough, this start is fantastic. Now, trying to figure out how to approach, this is the first great start we have. Obviously, we have a wonder right here that's gonna give us some science on all these tiles. Figuring out how I wanna best utilize this wonder, though, is actually kind of awkward because there's a lot of different things kind of weighing on my mind right now. The first thing is wanting to get this 4 science tile. You know, these are all 1 food, 1 gold, which isn't actually that great. So if I am gonna grab one of these tiles, I do want it to be the 4 science tile first. And if I come and settle on this tobacco, I kind of kill 2 birds with 1 stone. I get rid of a useless tobacco tile. I start collecting faith for my pantheon, and I get the 4 science tile right away. The problem with that is I don't have a lot of production. If I move up one here, I get this 2 science tile right away, or I can get the 2-2 to just grow a little bit first. Then I'll acquire the science. And by that point, I'll be able to get to the cocoa, which is a really good tile for us to work. The problem with that is then I haven't eliminated this kind of really silly tobacco tile that I don't really want. Either way, I've got a reef here for a decent campus, and we got some good tiles kind of in and around this area. The next thing is, you know, this would be a really obvious place to settle if I could settle there in two turns. I think considering the wonder, though, I think it makes the most sense to come and settle up on this tile right here, have access to all of this nice and early on, and forego the two-turn rule that I said was required earlier. I think in this one specific case, this is completely worth kind of rewriting my own rules. We're going to use our scout first to scout out, to double check, to see if everything's all good. And I think this is the best start for us. We're going to end up with access to all of these tiles anyway. However, the delay in taking the extra turn is made up for by the fact that I have 1, 2, 3 tiles in my immediate vicinity that are amazing. And I'm going to work into all this science as we grow, which is going to be very helpful for pushing me through the game. So this is definitely a great start. It's going to take a little bit to maneuver it, but there we are. We're going to make sure we're working this 2, 2, 3 tile. I do want this extra science, but I need the food and the production and the gold to kind of grow and be able to purchase some of these tiles farther away first, like this 4 science tile here, or this one here gives a little bit of production. But yeah, this is fantastic. I'm a huge fan of this start. Anything with a wonder, you know, not all wonders are the same, but this is really fun. So theoretically, this may not even be as good as some of the starts we've seen so far, but I'm going to call it great because this is just a very unique and fun start. So this is a great one. Have fun with this one. We have loaded in as Pachacuti here. There are a few things with Pachacuti that are different. The first is that he can work mountain tiles. So as we kind of settle, these mountain tiles will have yields on them, which is a little bit interesting. So you don't need to avoid the mountains as much. And they're going to give us +2 production and then +1 food for every adjacent terrace farm. And so there are some good synergies there with mountains that we're going to look to use. We're going to talk about this. And I talked about this earlier. Anytime you see one of these geothermal fissures next to a river, you probably just want to settle on that. So that is exactly what we're going to do. We are going to be able to work these mountains here. We can use a campus here. We can chuck down some terrace farms, which are very, very valuable. This is not the best Pachacuti start ever, but because it's Pachacuti, I'm not as worried about the lack of yields. These terrace farms give us food. They give us housing. They give us production for aqueducts and those types of things. +1 production if adjacent to fresh water. There's enough here that we can make this work. This is definitely a good start. It's also on a continent split, which will give us access to more. It's on a 3 continent split, which gives us access to so many luxury resources that it's probably worth this anyway. So I'm going to go with this is like perfectly okay. This is a perfectly okay start with the bonus of 3 continents. There's also a lot of good appeal if you wanted to build a preserve up in this area here. That might be fun. Oh boy, oh boy. So we are here as Bad Triou. Now, Bad Triou is unique because what we're looking for is a lot of woods, rainforest, or marsh to put our districts on. So it's good to have all of those things. The only thing here, though, is oh boy, is this start just straight bad. Now, it's not nearly as bad on lower difficulties because you've got a really good early Great Bath here. You're probably just not going to get the Great Bath on a higher difficulty, which means in one direction, you've got all this desert that you can't really do much with until you get the Petra, but even then it's not really enough desert to make the Petra good. You do have an early pyramids play, which is nice. It usually feels nicer, but this really isn't it. You got enough woods, rainforest, and marsh to put some districts on top of, but not in any real way where you can get some good district synergy in there. You can't plant any woods on any of these tiles. Now, obviously by the time you're thinking about planting the woods as Vietnam, you have more cities, but just as an initial starting location, this isn't my favorite. I think what I'm going to do though is come up here and just either probably can't settle the amber. Oh boy. Probably just settle this 2-1 tile right here. Give myself a good 2-2 tile to work with. Get away from this desert and maybe these floodplains that aren't going to be as useful to me and settle up here. But yeah, this isn't really my... I mean, continent split is nice. First meet on Jerusalem is nice, but that had nothing to do with where we put our city. This is not my favorite. This one is pretty terrible. I'm going to go with my first terrible rating. I feel terrible about this one. English Eleanor is interesting because we love all of this coastal stuff, Royal Navy dockyards, all of that kind of stuff, getting stuff for iron and coal mines and the like. But this start is pretty underwhelming. You know, I'm probably going to go and settle on this wine here just to get that rolling. The problem with that is that I'm even farther away from this 2-2 tile. If I move up here, not only do I move into the unknown, but I don't really want these floodplains anywhere near my capital city. So I suppose I end up, oh man, like this is, it's another start that's not not terrible, but I mean, it's not my favorite. There's no good harbor option either, which is pretty important. But I think a turn one settle here on the coast is nice, I guess. This is not my favorite. There's just a lack of everything. There's a lack of everything. This one's terrible. This one's terrible as well. Not my favorite, but I think I picked the best option. At least I'll have the wine to trade with. I used to be able to get drunk. I'll be able to get very, very drunk, and that makes me happier. Oh dear lord. Oh dear lord, holy. This is awful. We're ending the video here. This is the last one. I am tired and do not want to. Well, the good news is there's a couple decent tiles and there's fresh water. The bad news is literally everything else. This, on an actual level, this desert is just crippling. I can't build the Petra here for a long time. If I wanted to build the pyramids here ahead of the AI, I have to literally chop all of the good tiles in my city. So that's not really an option. The luxury resources around are all terrible and out of range. Like, this is just very bad. Also, if I want a 2-2 start, I have to get rid of this tile, or I have to get rid of the 2-2 to settle, get rid of the rainforest here to settle on it, and so I don't even get this chop. So this is, oh boy, oh boy. And there's floodplains. This is brutal. This is bad. This is terrible. This is the worst one. This is the worst one by so much. Let's settle on the incense, but man alive. We're gonna settle on the incense so we at least have that. We're gonna use the faith to tick up towards a pantheon, and then we can, oh, I guess this 3-2 tile helps a lot, but you can still work this 2-2 tile and then grow into this one here. Cotton is okay, I guess. This is terrible. This is very, very bad. And that's that, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the video, kind of taking a look at a few different types of starts with a few different leaders to kind of see what's good, what's not good, and what you guys should be looking for in your games. If you have any other comments about starts, feel free to throw them in the comments below. Hit up the description for links to our Twitch stream where we stream Civ a few times a week. Also, we have a thumbs up button that you should click and hit that subscribe button, of course. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next one.